Today's video is giving better understanding about the differences and resolve the mysteries of definition driven by ancient box about the DCS. So we'll go through the PLC and SCADA to understand what is the DCS offer. Let's find out. The first question, what is the PLC? Surely you came to this video not looking for the PLC history. So we just want to focus on the things that matter, not to waste time in useless stories. Simply, it's a programmable logic controller. So it's a controller where all the inputs and outputs are connected. And the user program will define how inputs influence the outputs. Unlike the classic control circuits, where we have wires, tons of relays, mechanical timers, counters, going in all directions. The way of programming and guidelines are defined through the IEC 61131-3 and basically two textual languages, instruction list and structure text, which Siemens named, by the way, SCL, and two graphical languages, the ladder and the function block diagram or the FBD, and one more sequential function chart, the SFC. By the way, the vendor extended one more hybrid languages called the CFC. So simply the PLC is the first layer and performing the direct control. PLC hardware is no more know-how. That's why we have tons of vendors with almost same specs and the competition mainly in the PLC software side. So for example, the IM262 here, the IM262 is having 3 nanoseconds per minute. The IM262 with the 3 nanoseconds per minute. So this IM262 is having 3 nanoseconds per instruction. That means it's reaching almost the high-end S7-1500 processors and exceeding almost every S7-400 processor's specs. It's really like the competition between Android phones and iOS phones. Hardware can reach endless possibilities where the software is not reaching the same level. The M221 from Schneider Electric is having better hardware specs compared to the S7-1200. But the software is limiting this potential and giving the leverage to S7-1200 all the way whenever there is no need for extra IOs, and you have full videos on this subject. By the way, the IM262 is a very aggressive offer where you have high performance hardware specs and Kutze's core software, the machine expert, with a cloud connectivity. And we would have a full video on this offer and other offers with the cloud connectivities and edge computing options. Back to the line. The second question, what is the SCADA? Supervisory control and data acquisition. And we have full videos about SCADA basics and look should be upside here. But simply it's a supervisory control through graphical user interface connected to your direct controller or the PLCs. So you can monitor your process, adding to this other functions like alarm management, trends, and maybe extend it further with a historian and reporting. And sometimes you get confused by vendor documents between SCADA software and SCADA system. Once we mention SCADA software, that means only software, which include 4 major components we mentioned earlier, the IO server, alarms, trends, and display clients. Considering the historian is an option. And most of the time when we talk or see SCADA system in a project BOQ, it refers to the full control system from the SCADA software to servers and monitors, and sometimes including the PLC panels. So what is the SCADA offer? SCADA is generic monitoring software built to connect to each and every component using industrial protocols drivers, or OBC, and it is loaded with tons of driver for this purpose. That's why we have vendors selling SCADA only, like Wonderware, Inductive Automation, Factory Studio, and Indusoft, where others are selling BLC only. And as you know, the big players are selling both of them, like Schneider, Rockwell, and Siemens. What is the DCS offer then? Before we go through this, what are the old ideas about DCS versus the PLC? PLC is small and fast for small projects and machines. DCS is huge, this size, maybe bigger than this size, and slow for bigger plants with several processes. Other talks about number of BLCs or controllers and several locations. Watch out, don't call it DCS application. It's called DCS database, or you'll be an idiot. But simply, DCS is a software package that includes or combines three parts: the PLC or controller software, SCADA visualization software, and application software sitting on top of them. So simply, it is one software platform for monitoring and control. More details. In a SCADA system, you are creating a motor block in the PLC software and then the faceplate in the SCADA software, and then connecting them, checking the suitable driver or OPC. In the DCS application generator, you will define the motor equipment in the DCS, and the DCS will take the role of generating the motor block in the PLC software and the motor faceplate in the SCADA, and connecting them, including alarms, trends, through symbol configuration check boxes. So here we have something called the DCS link, which is the major difference. PLC software and SCADA software are linked together. Any modification in the DCS layer or the DCS equipment will be implemented directly and consistently. So the PLC and SCADA will be updated, unlike the SCADA system workflow where you have to update both of them manually. So whenever you have a change, delete, or update in the DCS equipment, it will be reflected to both of them, the SCADA, the visualization part, and the PLC controller consistently, which would save a significant amount of time and give us the focus or more focus on the process rather than verifying several connection things. With this definition, we reach the main point. It is not a generic thing like SCADA. DCS would force you to use the same vendor for the PLC and SCADA, and we have other requirements limiting certain hardware platform with the DCS software. And some other vendors, they have controllers which are only dedicated for the DCS package. That's why we call it closed system. What else? DCS is having process library with the know-how and most of the time purchased separately for your industry, like water, cement, or pharmaceutical, etc., which will be significant starting point if you don't have sufficient knowledge about this industry. But don't be overwhelmed with this part, trust me. DCS library is built with a concept to include almost every condition or situation you think about. So you can easily change the configuration of motor signals, for example, without significant change. Back to the point, SCADA system versus DCS system. SCADA normally is concerned with separate tags, and the DCS is concerned with equipment or objects or even control loops. That's why you see SCADA in 10K, 20K, 50K, or 1 million tag. And when we talk about DCS, we talk about or count objects or equipment or even control loops, like 1,000 or 10,000 objects license. One more thing I forgot to mention about the DCS link between the SCADA software and PLC software, that this link will do further more functions vary from vendor to another, like navigation services, where you can reach the PLC application routine related to a certain equipment from the SCADA runtime screen. directly. And other like interlock diagrams and logic sequence visualization. The last question, where will the DCS system shine? First of all, DCS can be implemented in small and large scale system. That's why we have ranges of offer or the new offers to match your plant size and requirement from Siemens and Schneider, the hybrid DCS or the process expert and the BCS7. But this implementation will shine further when you have one of the following. One, large scale implementations. Object generation will be very effective and time saving. And this is what we call it bulk engineering. So it will extremely shine in this point. When the second point is when we have a good amount of communication integration, like hundreds of power meters or starters, DCS will create seamlessly all the communication assignments and functions with few clicks. So no mistakes, no overlapping in addresses or mapping the communication. But again, you have to use the same vendor equipment. So Siemens DCS, the PCS7, you have to use Siemens MCCs. Schneider DCS means you have to use Schneider MCCs. The summary, DCS has no relation with redundancy in servers, networks, or PLCs. DCS is distributed control system, which is nowadays have nothing to do with this name. And simply, it is consistent integrated framework. Error-free, sugar-free, pressure-free, setting-free, and have a nice day.